Hello class 12, this is your chemistry class and we are discussing about preparation of carboxylic acid. So let's continue the class. So in preparation of acids, we have discussed up to the halophone test, that is oxidation of methyl ketones having ketomethyl group, COCH3 group. Next is by oxidation of alkyl benzene. This part is important. This oxidation process involves in the preparation of many things actually this step has some application in some conversion in organic chemistry. So by oxidation of alkyl benzenes, oxidation of alkyl benzene. So here also we will use the strong oxidizing agent like acidified dichromate or alkaline potassium permanganate. So alkyl benzene means any alkyl group can be present here. So this R group can be methyl group, and it can also be CH2 CH3, that is ethyl group, and it can also be any isopropyl group like this. So they are all alkyl groups actually, and they can be present in the benzene ring. So when we use the oxidizing agent like either we consider dichromate H2SO4 or you just or KMnO4 alkaline KMnO4 OH minus under hot condition. Okay, alkaline KMnO4 obviously in under hot condition. In hot condition KMnO4 acts as an oxidizing agent, but in cold condition it does hydroxylation. Okay, so hot condition should be maintained here. So directly it will be converted into benzoic acid. Okay, so when this R is methyl, its name is toluene, you know, and when this R is CH2CH3, its name is ethyl benzene, isopropyl benzene. So whatever is it, if you oxidize it by strong oxidizing agent, it will be converted in one step to benzoic acid. So due to the higher reactivity of benzylic hydrogens as compared to other hydrogens on the alkyl chain, oxidation occurs at this carbon atom, and thus all alkyl benzene give the same benzoic acid. So it is saying about that the higher reactivity of benzylic hydrogen, which one is benzylic position? So if I say that this one is CH2H, so this one is benzylic group PHCH2. This PHCH2 group is benzylic group, and these hydrogens are known as benzylic hydrogens, and these benzylic hydrogens are actually very much active. If you consider with normal alkyl hydrogens, in comparison to normal alkyl hydrogen, benzyl hydrogens are actually more active. So whenever benzylic hydrogens are present, whatever the group is, if it is methyl, ethyl or isopropyl, the same product will be obtained here. Next is by the hydrolysis of alkyl cyanides or nitriles, and this oxidation method is also important, that is involved in the preparation or the conversions of many organic compounds. That oxidation of alkyl cyanides or nitriles, okay. Oxidation of alkyl cyanides or nitriles, so it is just RCN, C triple bond A, and it was just hydrolysis. If you do the hydrolysis, acidified hydrolysis, H3O plus, okay. So dilute, this is the acidified hydrolysis. Acidified hydrolysis. Then it will be, this CN portion will be converted to COOH. So CN portion will be converted to COOH. So if you just take methyl cyanide, you will get acetic acid, methyl cyanide. By this process, you will get CH3COOH, acetic acid. So this is the another method for the preparation of acids. And if you take benzonitrile, PHCN, then you will get benzoic acid. So you can convert benzoic acid by taking alkyl benzene, and you can also just do the acidified hydrolysis of benzonitrile. Next is from Brickner reagent. Brickner reagent can react with carboxylic carbon dioxide gas. Carbon dioxide gas acts as a source of COOH group. So when Brickner reagents react with carbon dioxide gas, then we will get the acid, carboxylic acid. So suppose methyl magnesium bromide reacting with carbon dioxide gas, then we will get CH3COOH after the hydrolysis step. Okay, H2 plus. So what happens here actually? So if you just see the structure of carbon dioxide, the structure of carbon dioxide looks like this, and you know that there is a reversal of polarity in the Brickner reagent. So in Brickner reagent, this alkyl portion is delta negative, and magnesium being electro positive metal element, so that will be delta positive. So that is reversal of polarity. So this delta negative part acts as a nucleophile and can attack this carbonyl carbon atom, and it will open like this. So CH3 has a connection with this carbon atom. So CH3C, this carbon atom is this carbon, and C double bond O is opening as O minus. It is opening as O minus, and it is double bond O. So you can see that this is same. That is the salt. So O minus MgBr plus. That is the salt. So when you do the hydrolysis by aqueous NH4Cl or just NH3H0 plus acidified hydrolysis, you will get CH3COH and double bond O. That is acetic acid. So here you can see that you have just taken methyl magnesium bromide, and you are increasing the number of carbon atoms by this carbon dioxide gas, and this carbon dioxide gas is the source of COOH group. It is the source of COOH group. Okay. So this is another method for the preparation of acids. Next one important method is the hydrolysis of esters. Okay, hydrolysis of esters. Hydrolysis of ester. So if we just hydrolyze any ester, that means RC double bond to OR prime. This is the ester moiety. And if we do the hydrolysis, that is, it can be acidic hydrolysis or alkaline hydrolysis, any one you can afford. So hydrolysis when we do, so here at this portion, that is the carbonyl carbon atom linked with the ester group, okay, alkoxide group, carbonyl carbon atom linked with the alkoxide group, that is the ester linkage. This is the ester linkage. Okay, this ester linkage will be clipped. So here we will get RC double bond O, O minus, or just OH hydrolysis we have done, and R prime OH. So one part we will get alcohol and other part we will get acid. So you can do both acidic hydrolysis or you can do the alkaline hydrolysis. Okay, anyone you can afford. But the product will be same, that is the ester linkage will be broken, and we will get this left hand part will give the acid and the right hand part will give the alcohol. So this type of preparatory methods we generally use for the preparation of carboxylic acid. These are main preparation, and one other preparatory method we can predict, that is from malonic acid or alkyl malonic acid. So the malonic acid is just like this, CH2C double bond OH, C double bond OH. This one is malonic acid. Okay, this one is named as malonic acid. So when we just heat this malonic acid at nearly 100 to 150 degrees Celsius, carbon dioxide gas will be eliminated like this. So here you can see that this portion is eliminated as carbon dioxide gas, okay, minus carbon dioxide gas eliminated, and we are getting CH3COOH acetic acid we are getting from malonic acid. So what about if we are trying to prepare any other acid that is other than acetic acid? So malonic acid is giving, when we heat malonic acid, it is giving acetic acid. But if we try to prepare suppose propanoic acid, propanoic acid we are trying to prepare. So just take one derivative of this malonic acid, that is alkyl malonic acid. So just replace one hydrogen atom at this carbon atom with any alkyl group. Suppose I am taking there have the CH3 group, CH, COOH, COOH like this. That is alkyl malonic acid, and we are doing the same thing, that is heating it. So here carbon dioxide gas will be eliminated and we will get CH3, CH2, COOH. So you can see that this one is propanoic acid. So acetic acid, propanoic acid, both we can get from malonic acid and the derivative of malonic acid. So these are the some preparatory methods for the preparation of carboxylic acids. And in the next class, we will discuss about the physical properties of carboxylic acids.